pathogenicity?
When we deal with disease cycles, we talk about primary inoculum. That's the first stuff that comes up in the ear. If you have a way of decreasing the primary inoculum, keeping the primary inoculum down, you will have less disease. Secondary inoculum comes afterwards. Not all pathogens produce secondary inoculum. And that's important to understand the difference in there as well, because we get different kinds of pathogen cycles depending on how much inoculum we have. We're going to look at two very distinctive types of diseases. This says it's monocyclic. Mono means one. Cyclic means cycle. So you get one cycle per growing season. And it starts out when the primary inoculum comes in. You get dispersal of that inoculum. You get the infection court, which is where you get the germination followed by the obligate moisture period and then eventually colonization, where you have symptom development coming from that. And then you get survival of this pathogen from 1 year to the next. And there are a lot of different types of organisms that go through a monocyclic type of pathogenicity. We also have the polycyclic type of pathogenicity. And these tend to be a little bit more specialized, and these often tend to be a lot more problematic because they just take off. This is like flu when it comes in. It just goes crazy. You start out with your primary inoculum. You get dispersal of the primary inoculum. You get your infection court, followed by infection and colonization. Then you get secondary inoculum produced, and you get dispersal of the secondary inoculum, which leads to the infection court and the infection and colonization part, and then you get more secondary inoculum. And that part just repeats itself. So rather than having one cycle per growing season, we're now going to have many. And when we get into the part on epidemiology, we're going to talk about how problematic these particular things actually are. And after that, you get survival. And the survival is going to allow for the production of primary inoculum again in the following year. So when we look at it, a polycyclic disease is a little bit different than a monocyclic, but it can be a whole lot more problematic because it's constantly being propagated and producing problems. Some of the other terms that we need to understand in here include things like alternate hosts. An alternate host is a host that also serves to harbor the pathogen. It may not be the primary host we're looking at as far as that particular pathogen, but there are a lot of alternate hosts out there. These allow for what we call overwintering. Overwintering is where the pathogen is able to survive during the time when there is no host growth or there is not a favorable host there. Overwintering can also occur on crop residue. You have the plant gets harvested, you leave the residue out there, and the next thing you know is the residue is keeping the pathogen around so that it can survive. We have survival on structures of infected plants. The sclerotia that we saw and that we will see are quite problematic as far as being able to allow pathogens to survive. And then we have infected seeds. And any time you have an infected seed, that can allow for a significant amount of pathogen survival, and it can also allow for a significant amount of primary inoculum in the spring. And we saw that with damping off. So when we look at it, it becomes very important. So all of these terms become important in our ability to understand disease and see how we can take disease forward for the eventual thing of trying to control